Let's start with Turkey. There's a lot of talk about emerging markets. Let's talk about Turkey. I'll put a chart up here, actually, that shows the weakening of the lira, which is that white line there. This is dollar lira, so the higher the number, the lower the lira. And the blue is inflation, which is up over 15% right now. There are various reports that investors are really nervous at this point about Turkey. Where are you on Turkey?
Yep. Listen, one has to be nervous about Turkey. Turkey's main challenge is the current account deficit, which is roughly 6% of GDP. So in a more difficult environment with U.S. rates moving higher, the question is, well, how will Turkey fund that deficit? And the burden is on Turkey to do everything right, and it actually looks like they're doing just about everything wrong. And so first, in terms of the appointment of the new cabinet and economics team, he chose his son-in-law as opposed to a more orthodox economist. The market was looking for a rate hike earlier in the week, and they left rates unchanged. And then yesterday, a squabble with the U.S. and a threat from the U.S. administration on sanctions. So it's a vicious cocktail.
Well, let's talk about that for a minute, because I think we have actually the president's statement saying that there are going to be severe sanctions against Turkey because of their refusal to release this minister, this U.S. Pastor who's been over there. Is there a real prospect of U.S. sanctions against Turkey at this point, economic?
Well, you know, the U.S. has the ability. The U.S. administration has used sanctions, against a number of regimes. I think if you just listen to the headlines, I think sanctions are likely. I would also say that I think the sanctions obviously take different forms. There's different levels of severity. I would think the initial sanctions on Turkey, would be quite modest, potentially dealing with, arms, the military sector. They probably wouldn't be outright financial sanctions, but we'll have to wait and see.